parties?
Yes.
So we have Jim Powell from Northwest Pavement over in Washington State.
Yep.
And he was at the Joint Engineers Conference in Helena and gave a presentation on pavement, which I found interesting. I'd always remembered when they did the interstate highway system, how they kind of made it kind of thin so you'd have continual employment fixing it all the time, whereas the Germans make theirs a wee bit thicker and level over the last 50 years. And I found out from his presentation, it doesn't take much more thickness to make it last decades longer. An extra inch or two is about all it takes. I don't want to give away this spiel here. And so he had an excellent presentation on doing roads, parking lots, and all the tricks and techniques, especially if you're going to make them out of concrete instead of asphalt. So without further ado,
okay,
I'll introduce you.
So I'll mix it around a bit. This isn't the exact presentation I gave there. This is more one here towards designing and specifying constructible and cost-effective payments. But we can divert and talk about any topic you want or any subject matter you need. Just a little about my background and who I am. I'm the executive director for the Northwest chapter of the American Concrete Paving Association. And that's a mouthful to say when you answer the phone. I've been doing this for about 19 years. I am a PE, I'm not a salesman or anything like that. Prior to that, I was with the Federal Highway Administration for about 8 years as a construction and materials engineer, and was also the lead instructor for the National Highway Institute's concrete materials course. So any questions you might have about concrete materials as well, I'm more than qualified to answer them. If I don't have the answer, I'll find it for you. I'm not afraid to tell you I don't know if I don't know something. Most of what I know is about pavements, but unfortunately I know as much about asphalt pavements as I do concrete. So I can answer those questions, although I can't tell my neighbors. And prior to that, I guess actually I've been working with concrete since I got out of high school. I had 3 scholarships and thought I was too smart to go to school. So I gave them all up, went out and got a job pouring concrete, and all I got was poor and married out of that. So I went back to school and got both my bachelor's and master's in civil. And I've been dealing with concrete ever since I started pushing wheelbarrows. I've pretty much been in love with it and teaching them about it and constructing it, designing it. One of the problems that we have with concrete pavements in general, and with a lot of designs that I run into, not just with concrete. I remember one of the projects I worked on as a laborer, actually I was a rod buster tying steel at that time, and the steel wouldn't fit into forms. And so I asked the project engineer, I said, how am I supposed to do this? And his only reply was, well, it worked on paper. So one of the things you have to remember when you're dealing with something in paper is it may not work in the field. So be very careful when you're designing things. We can talk a little bit about pavement, and again, interrupt me at any point, any questions you might have. I'm here to answer questions that you have, not necessarily just to feed you information. We'll talk just very briefly about some of the things that you might deal with on concrete pavements. But really, the big things that are going to affect your bidding when you're talking about that and your costs, thickness is relatively minor. The details, your material and your equipment requirements, your geometrics, all of those things have a huge impact on your cost. And that's one of the things that you need to consider if you're pricing out or you're bidding concrete flat work. On the design side, Matt mentioned that a lot of concrete out there was built thinner than it needed to be. Anybody here have any experience or taken any classes in pavements? Pavement design in general. Okay, how long do we typically design pavements for?
Asphalt or concrete?
Asphalt, anything. Typical, what's the typical design life for a pavement? What'd you learn in class?
I think asphalt is like 12 years, something like that.
That's a common performance life. Most of our structural designs are done for 20 years. Generally, that's what engineers always learn, 20-year design for a pavement. And when I asked, when I was in school, and I asked why is 20 years used, my profs told me that, well, that's because we can't accurately project